we should probably do a before and after, right? So let's hear what it sounds like before. Oh, nothing, there's no music. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you for stopping by. Today we have the Low Rider ST and we are putting on the Rockford Fosgate sound system. So when Anthony picked up his Road Glide ST at Spitzy's Harley-Davidson in Albany, I had them do a search and they were able to get in one of these bad boys because they're tough to get. They've been on back order just like everything else. And when you go on Harley's website, it's not until 2023 at least. And that's what most dealers will tell you. I called a lot of them. I just had good timing, I guess, since Spitzy's is the best. So they were able to get one for me. I think they're a little over $1,000. So it's a little pricey of a mod. It's my short glide, so I've never had music on a bike before. I never really cared to have music, but seeing Anthony always have music on his, I don't know, just there's something about it that I kind of want. Everyone I talk to says how impressed they are with the sound system. So I'm pretty confident that this is going to be killer. Otherwise, I wouldn't have spent the money on it. There's plenty of other aftermarket things you can get, but this is very clean. It sits right in there like it came that way. It's made for this bike and it's made for the ST fairing. It's not one size fits all for any bike. Speakers sitting all over the place. It sits inside, streamlined. That's why I wanted it. That's why I didn't mind paying the money for it. I can't forget the ponytail scale. I'm probably gonna have to come back here at the end and tell you how hard it was. Because if I had to guess by looking at this, there's literally a wiring harness and the speakers, I would say a 2 at the most, but I have a feeling that's not the case. Maybe it'll be a 3, I have no idea. If you're new here, the ponytail scale is a difficulty scale. I give that on all my installs, just so you kind of know how easy or difficult the job is gonna be. Not sure yet. Usually I can kind of figure it out beforehand, but I'm not really sure how it's gonna go because, like I said, I've seen some videos and people have said it's a lot more difficult than they thought. So we'll see if that's true or not, but I guess let's get to it. So what we're gonna do first is we're going to take the seat off and then we're gonna take the side covers off so we can get to the battery and all that fun stuff. Why yes, Heather, a ratchet would be very helpful right now. Listen, if you guys have been here a while, you know, like, I had a pretty sweet setup. I had a huge toolbox full of all the goodies I could want. Right now, all of our stuff's in storage, traveling back and forth to Georgia every couple weeks. So I don't have my shop, I don't have a setup, but you know what? You don't need all the best specific tools for every little thing. Use what you got, that's what we're gonna do. So before you're like, oh, what are you doing? This would make it so much easier. I know it would, okay? I know it would, but I don't have it right now. Looks like we gotta get to the positive battery terminal, which is covered by this battery tray. So we're gonna have to do a little messing around here to take all of this out so we can get to that positive terminal. How I'm gonna get this thing back on, I have no idea. They make this look so easy. It's not that it's hard, it's just a pain because there's no slack in any of this wire. I think I can get away with just leaving it loose and pulled out a little bit without taking it all the way out. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, all right, cool. Cool, 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 cool. All right, let's remove the positive terminal. Comes out. It's just kind of clipped in here. I can put this on now. I guess this just kind of clips in where we took that last piece off. Fingers crossed. I'll show you where the screws go. Right under here, looks like you throw some screws in there that they give you. So let's open this guy. All right, two screws here. Now we're gonna put the jumper harness on. Now there's a fairing harness in here that we got to take out. We have the pin we just loosened from the fairing. So the back of this connector is numbered. You want number 11, so you're gonna have to count. I can kind of see the pin sticking up a little bit here, so I might not have too much trouble. But you're gonna go in with your little dental pick here and you're going to loosen, there's the two holes in the middle. So you go in and you just push it in to click it. Maybe. So this is supposed to just kind of pop a little bit. You're not supposed to take it out all the way because all the pins could fall out.
Many hours later.
Nope. But he did order it, so tomorrow morning.
The next day.
Oh, I got it.
What?
I got it.
You did?
I did.
All right, well.
Do you want to wait?
No, you did it now.
You want me to pull it out?
No, you did it now.
Well, I'll push it back in.
No, don't.
Oh,
no.
Oh, okay, don't push it back in.
All right, well, we got...
Well, you can still show them the motion. Go ahead. Do what you gotta do.
So this was still too big. The taper got too wide, so didn't go in far enough like we needed it to. What did you use? The safety pin?
Yeah, I used the safety pin.
We found a safety pin.
Yes.
We found a safety pin. I chopped the point off of it. That was going to be our backup. And that's what we were going to do, but he decided to go ahead and, you know.
Yeah, I got it.
He got it, though. We also bought some stronger picks because the other ones were bending. I think those were dental picks.
And for cleaning your teeth.
Yes.
See what I did here? So I'm going to push the pin in there. Right in here.
Yeah, safety pin.
Yeah, with the tip cut off it.
Yeah.
Pushed it in. That's the thing, the paper clip wasn't rigid enough.
Right.
So then I pushed it right down in there until it almost clicked. Like there was almost like I felt it, like it stopped.
Mm-hmm.
And I pushed it a little harder and I felt something like depress. And then I just grabbed a hold of this here, gave her a little tug. Can I do it?
Go ahead.
Okay.
You can have the glory. Okay. You wanna wait for me.
Look at that.
So now we gotta put that little part of the harness back where we took that pin out from and make sure it is the correct orientation.
So like this.
That way.
Yeah. If you look at the clip, you see it right there. The little channel there.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You see that little groove?
Ah,
push that white piece back
down. Push the white piece back down.
Yep.
All right, so now we have to put this back together. He's just gonna clip that together and put it back.
Yep.
Headlight jumper. And then that's gonna go to the headlight when you put the fairing back on. All right, now we got another one of these fun pins to do.
Oh, sorry.
So we have to get this pin here.
You gotta push that. It's a setup.
Show how that works.
You slide this out,
yeah.
Which you use the pick tool to kind of help you lift the red tab. Once you got that red tab pulled back, you can push down on that black tab.
So that's not the one we need, but we got that
just
out of
the way.
Just
getting that away.
That's what we have to do with this one, but it's under
right.
This bracket and it makes it a giant pain. There's no brakes. Sir?
I'm trying to run a business.
You're gonna loosen up that white piece.
Yeah, that inner white piece again.
Find number 9.
Which is that standalone right there.
Do
in
the
that
same
row.
Thing.
Do the same thing that we fought
Hopefully
with before.
It goes
smoother.
Smoother. Now that we spent 3 hours practicing on the first one.
Mm-hmm. I'll grab my magic pin.
Oh,
ah.
Son of a... Look at that! Shit.
Ah.
This is the harness.
That goes on the power.
That goes down here.
Yeah, that's your... Okay.
They give you this fuse, so we're gonna throw that in here. And then now we're gonna hook this up to the battery terminal that we disconnected.
Positive battery terminal.
Pretty much what we took off, now we're just gonna hook it all up again and hopefully it goes easy. Then on this side, I'm gonna put our fuse back in here. Before we get any further, we're gonna just make sure this works. So the thing about this is kind of stinks. There's no control. There's no hand controls for this. It's all in the app. I don't know how I feel about that. Hopefully it works with my voice control and my helmet, because that's a little dangerous. But we'll see how it goes. So I downloaded the Harley-Davidson audio powered by Rockford Fosgate app, and now we got to turn the bike on and connect it and do all that fun stuff, and then we'll see if it works. Pray. Of course, you have to update it. Hey, that wasn't even halfway.
Holy sh!
All right, it's getting a little dark in here, so we're almost done. Pretty much, we just have to clean up the wiring here, make sure it's all pretty and tucked in, and then I have one more thing to do on the fairing, and it's just put it all back together. All right, so under on the fairing, there's these clips here. That has to come off. And that has to come off. I don't know why we didn't do that while I was on the bike, but I'm gonna take those two off before I put this back on. All right, guys, that's gonna do it for this video. Sounds awesome. Not plug and play. It's a little more involved than just plug and play. Plug and play to me is plug it in and go. That was a little bit of a project. Not terrible. If it wasn't for the pin, it wouldn't be so bad, but man, those pins made it real difficult. And just getting to stuff was difficult. So frustration scale, super high. But I would say probably a 3 ponytail job. I can't say it was like a 4, but it's 3 ponytails with a lot of patience. I think that's a better way to describe it. 3 ponytails, a lot of patience. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Have you heard one before? Dude, I haven't even, this thing is stupid loud. Dude, it's killer. It's, I'm excited to ride with it a little bit. So obviously first impressions, super loud, sounds really good. Stay tuned for the next video where we actually ride it and I talk about it a little bit. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell icon so you're notified whenever we put out new videos. And until next time, you ride safe. We'll catch you on the next one.